Good evening to Renelyn Samiano. Reconnecting, so hopefully that you will connect in our lecture. This is just continuation of what we have discussed this morning. Anyway, our students are invited to watch, just for you to have advanced learning on the topic. Okay, so good evening to everybody. So we have here Jesamay Tagaka, Arnold Valderrama, we have Brian Macabalo, si Lorlin Fabre, so we have Lyndon Aldo. I am sorry, we are facing very bad condition on the signal. We have Grizel, so Erica May Pagod, si Laarni Salibad, nakapsutinet ko na ni Arnold. Yes, Arnold, nakapsutinet. We have also ayan, si Bia Marie. Ayan, so si Maria. Good evening, Maria. Hopefully, you have took your food. Mahinang signal. At, have a little Monje or Maria Monje. Ayan, si Lisette Lorenzo. We have also Nathan Batad. We have Sarah Jane Cabias. Okay, si Cabias. We have Dave Chanel. Si Lisette. We have Joel Feliciano, Axel Lalupay. We have Blanco and Mark David. So, mamaya, I will again mention your name, especially those who are not yet mentioned. So we will just start. We have also Agpuldo. Yan. Good evening, Miss Agpuldo. Si Rodriguez. Okay, so ngayon, we'll start now. We have the Roman Empire. Dito, pag-usapan natin yung a little bit history of the so-called law enforcement all over the world. Okay? Kasi we cannot go further without having discussion on the history. Kasi nga, ika nga ni Jose Rizal, hindi tayo makakarating sa ating paruroonan kung hindi tayo lilingon sa ating pinanggalingan. So, yung sa history talaga is very important para at least we connect. We connect and then we will study. We will study yung tinatawag nating development of the law enforcement organization all over the world, most especially, of course, our organization, our very own law enforcement here in the Philippines, okay? Law enforcement agencies here in the Philippines. Pasensya kayo, mga kapatid. Yan, so medyo okay. The name of Mr. Augustus or Emperor Augustus, this was 14 AD or 27 BC, introduced the Praetorian Guard or the so-called Praefectus Urbi or the Vigiles of Rome or Vigiles of Rome. Ito, of course, we know already what is Rome before. Pagka Rome, malakas na area, malakas na country, a place where civilization started, okay? And of course, even this so-called policing system, sabihin na lang nating meron silang great contribution. Si Adelaida Tibes, Leia, good evening. Kain ka na. Okay, so RJ Guillermo and Umlas. Okay, so we've here, as I said well back, Roman Emperor Augustus introduced this naman. Okay, mainly the purpose of this is to protect, to guard, or to watch, of course, the area where they are staying. And the people who are involved here, are only those citizens, are also those citizens rather. We have the Praetorian Guard. Yung Praetorian Guard natin, considered this as the first police officer or police organization in the Rome, which the purpose of this is to protect the palace of the emperor. Okay? Protect the palace of the emperor. Ang tawag dyan ay Praetorian Guard. Sila yung unang officers. And those officers are solely assigned to, yan yung pinakamataas sa isang area. Siyempre sa Rome, mahilig sila yung mga yun, emperor, mga great, mga king, okay? Pero dito, yung emperor, he tasked a group of people, he called it as the Praetorian Guard. Praetorian Guard. So, solely or mainly, the purpose of this is to protect the palace and of course, the people on the palace. Sino yun? And of course, the emperor. Okay? The emperor. Yan yung Praetorian Guard under Roman Emperor Augustus. It was 14 AD. Okay? So, we have another one. Itong si Augustus introduced three. Tatlo yan. Una is the Praetorian Guard. Pangalawa is yung Praefectus Urbi or the Urban Cohort. Ano ba yung Urban Cohort na yan? And what is the function of this? What is the function of this? The function of this is different from the function of Praetorian Guard. Yung Praefectus Urbi, yung Urbi kasi, yung Urbi, the other term of that is Urban. Urban. So, big sabihin, pagka Praefectus Urbi, their function is to protect the city. Protect the city and they exercise both executive and judicial power. So, big sabihin yan, ito, sila bilang police, kasi they protect the city eh. So, police sila. At the same time, they are exercising the executive and judicial power. So, para silang part of the, ano, parang sa atin kasi pag sinabing executive, sa president yan eh. Tapos judicial, saan yan? Sa justice. So, ito, mga police noon, under yung Roman Empire Augustus, sila ay napakaraming function. Functions. Biruin mo, police officer ka, the same time, you are under the executive, another one, judicial. So, judge ka pa, or maybe, magistrate. Okay? Napakarami. Pero, siyempre, on the development of this organization, siyempre, sa sobrang dami ng trabaho mo, you cannot perform well. So, siguro, as we notice this time, pag sinabi police, on enforcers lang sila. Iba pa yung tinatawag, iba na yung mga nasa judicial, mga executive, okay? Sa Pilipinas, as we discussed before, sa Pilipinas, we have three branches of the government. We have the judicial or judiciary. We have also yung tinatawag nating legislative and the executive. Okay? They have different functions and they function individually. Ayan, so, pero dito, nung unang panahon, especially doon sa Rome, under Emperor Augustus, yung mga polis ay, they have multiple tasks, okay? Meron silang napakaraming trabaho. Pero ngayon, as we notice, kasi as I said while back, we compare yung organization noon at saka ngayon. Ngayon, ang mga police natin ay solely, purpose is to enforce laws. Okay? Another one, we have also another thing that Augustus presented or made under his reign, yung Vigils of Rome or Vigiles of Rome. What is this? Ano naman ang trabaho ng vigil na to? They are working as firefighters. Firefighters. And the other term of this is yung vigilante. Vigilante. Itong mga vigilante na to, they quite move or perform their functions brutally. Definitely, ang vigils of road, unang-una, ang ilang function is to protect the community from fire. Okay? From fire. So, sila ay firefighters. Ngayon, itong tatlo na ito na ginawa ni Augustus or Emperor Augustus. Una is yung Praetorian Guard. Secondly is the Praefectus Urbi. And thirdly is the Vigils of Rome. Ngayon, kung napapansin nyo, merong pagkakahalin tulad ngayon. In our tribures, merong kasi dito mga fire personnel. Itong Praefectus Urbi, because this is assigned in the city, o mga police, kung naman natamatan. And then Praetorian Guard, ito naman assigned in the palace. Okay? Parang they protect the palace alone. Ngayon, para siyang BGMP that they protect one place only. So now, people, in our organization, yung PNP or yung tribures natin, they copied or sabi na lang natin they use this as a template. Yung ginawa ni Augustus or Roman Emperor Augustus. Ayan, so yan yung una na subject natin, especially dito sa sabi na lang natin history. Okay, so basahin ko ulit yung mga pangalan ng nakapasok dito. We have Jethro Lakshmi, si Umukit, Jethro Kamayang, Jia Duyor, Eric Lagarico, Jerry Gabriel, J.M. Rivera, si Dominic Abad, okay, si Dominic, Christian Jess Agriam, James Corpus, we have also Hazel Alcon, yan, si King Gay, Fredelin Oliero, okay, Mr. Sugitan, good evening, my friend, Poging Nilalang, good evening, Pogi, baka pugot mat, ay, joke lang, Shane Aguinaldo, we have Raymart Panyo, si Jericho Rosales, ay, Jericho Agnir, pala. We have Eduardo Gorospe, DJ Jopet, si May Ann Silvestre, si Rhea Bumagat, si Marisol Reyes, Jineline Akdal, we have also Pasqua, Carlo Taghoy, si Mika Balanay, Ching Acacio, then Lamataw, Mary Christine, and April Dina Alegado. Okay, so let's continue. Aside from Roman Emperor Augustus, and aside from what he gave and what he presented that contributed much in the so-called enforcement all over the world, meron din tong tinatawag natin the Statute of Winchester. Yung Statute of Winchester, ito naman ay sa England. So, England, still, ito mga countries na to, sa Europe yan eh. So, dito nag-umpisa talaga yung development of so-called policing. Policing. Sir, sa Pilipinas, do we have that? Well, meron din tayo. But, of course, dito sa England, particularly, at saka sa Rome, eh, mas marami yung kanilang contribution. Mas marami. Sa 1285 AD. Ano man ito? Itong Statute of Winchester enacted or established a rudimentary criminal justice system. Biruin mo, noon meron na silang criminal justice system. Ayan yung ano. So ngayon, yung Statute of Winchester able to made or enacted itong tinatawag nating rudimentary criminal justice system. In the Philippines, we have criminal justice system also. Hmm? At dito, may siyang ibinigay. They made this treating also. Anong mga to naman? Pag sinabi natin kasing criminal justice system, or meron tayong process yan. Merong sistema. Kung merong nagkasala, ano ba yung sistema ang gagamitin? Hindi yung hindi pa nagkakasala, hindi pa napatunayan, pinapatay mo na siya, or you are giving sanction. So, dapat yung merong system. Tingnan mo, napakagaling tong Statute of Winchester. Hmm? Napakagaling na ito at contribution reinforcement. So we have here, number one is the watchman and ward. Ano ba ito? Ano bang purpose ng watchman and ward? Hmm? Or the other term of the watchman and ward is the bellman or Charlies. Bakit Charlies or bellman? Ito kasi, it was adopted under the name of King Charles. Kaya nga naging Charlies. Hmm? It was adopted from the name of King Charles. Ito naman sa England, siyempre may king ang mga yan eh. May kingdom kasi doon, England. Ngayon, what is the purpose of the watchman and ward? Watchman and ward. Ano purpose nito? Unang-una is to patrol streets. Okay. To patrol streets. And to look into those local people, na especially at night time, kasi gabi talaga yan. Especially at night time, on their houses, that no one is roaming around in the town. Hmm? Yan yung purpose nating tinatawag na watchman and ward. Nagpapatrol yan. Ngayon, kung napapansin nyo, may mga police officer, they are doing that patrol. Hmm? Especially night time. Bakit, sir? Kasi during night time, nagsilabasan yung mga manginginom, may mga masasamang balak. Hmm? Yung mga nagre-remedyo pa ng mga pulutan dyan. Pero ngayon, panahon na ito, itong watchman, hindi na tinatawag na watchman. Ang tawag na sa kanila ay police office. And they have the same function. Anong function yan? It's to patrol the area. Ano bang purpose ng patrolling or patrol? Well, the purpose of that is to observe. And if there are people who are doing, sabi na lang natin, anomalies or problem, immediately they will arrest it. Or mga nanggugulo, yan. So the purpose of that is to arrest those persons. They bring it into the nearest police station. Then, no nabartik data, they will put it maybe in lock para hindi pa makalabas, makapag-create ng problem. Okay, so yung watchman and ward, or the other term of that is the bellman or Charlies. Una, ang function nila is to patrol the streets. Biro mo, ang patrol nila is pag nagrabi ita, no garabi, aging ganat kwa, aging ganat bigat, pangon, mas jay. Like what these police officers do now, that they really do patrolling from morning to night to morning to night. So, ibig sabihin 24/7. 24/7. But not the same police officer. Merong tinatawag na relievo. Biro mo, may mga police tayo na nag-wawin during night. Pag natin yung mga police nandyan pa, pa-patrol. The purpose of that is, of course, to ready arrest people if there are really problems or anomalies or crime that on progress. Okay. Another one is another function of the watchman and ward. Ito yung performing duties such as lighting street lamps. Ito nung unang panahon wala pa naman silang kuryente, so ang ginagawa ng mga night or watchman and ward ay nagpapasindi ng ilaw. May street light na sila noon pero hindi matik. Hindi Hindi parang what we use this time, yung kuryente, kasi wala pa namang kuryente nung unang panahon eh. Ngayon, what they light or what they activate as their lights are lamps. Ano pa? Ano ba yung function ng mga watchman? They clear garbages on the street. Nagagagat dagiti police ID niya. Suda ti para sindi ti sila, suda para patay, suda pwede para dalus iti basura. But there are still activities like enforcing the criminal law. Of course, enforcer sila. Kasi noon meron na silang batas pertaining to the criminal or those really violating a such. Yan. So mga kapatid, ito na yung function ng mga kapulisan natin ngayon, yung enforcing and people. Then if there are violators, they give tickets. They put a person in jail and so on. They really investigate. Ito yung mga enforcing the criminal law. Okay? Ngayon mga kapatid, itong function ng watch and ward, we also see this to the function of police officers this time. Makikita tayo. And sino itong mga watch and ward members? Sino sila? Typically, they are the member of the society also. They are the member of society. Ayan. So, ayan mga kapatid. Saglit lang. 1 minute. Okay, so pasensya na kayo, medyo kon lang. Mayroong konting isturbo. Ayan, so shout out nga pa kay Jepong diyan saka kay Aldung and kay Bricks, yung mga lasenggo diyan. But anyway, they are good. So let's continue in our discussion. Nandito yung Statute of Winchester. Yung tatlo na ibinigay, particularly to improve the system, especially in enforcement. Una is the watchman and ward. Pangalawa is yung hue and cry system. Ano naman yung hue and cry system? The requirement for good people to shout and come to the aid of people in distress from a crime in order to ensure that the hue and cry could be enforced. The statute further established the assize of pagsigaw ng tao, yung tao na yan, he will go to the middle of the town maybe, then shout, they will pour a help, they will cry for help, and he cries. After that, our crying, hindi yung crying, literally crying. Crying is begging for help. After that, somebody will help this person and then they will seize the person who made the criminal. Yung lahat ng mga male, bin to 60. They equip to 60. They equip themselves. Then they will keep the so-called peace. And after that, if somebody will ask for help, they will go. They will really help the person who is crying for help. Ayan, yung hue and cry system. Still, this is under the statute of Winchester. Another one is yung number three that this statute of Winchester gave is the parish constables. Ano ba yung parish constables? Or constabulary, constables. Primarily, the function of this is to laws on the urban, especially on the on the area, especially in England. Okay? And this constable supervise the watch and ward. Diba? Magkakasama kasi ito eh. Itong tatlo na to magkakasama. Yung the watch and ward, the hue and cry, and the parish constable. And yung parish constable, ito yung pangatlo na ibinigay. The purpose of this, as I said well back, is to enforce laws and to supervise yung watch and ward. Okay? Now, itong parish constable, ito ay assigned in a larger districts. In a larger districts. So, dakdakkel di ko ang mas malaki yung sakop nito. Mas malaki yung sakop. Kaya din ngayon sa atin law enforcement organization ngayon, may mga mas maliit yung sakop, may mas malaki, something like that. So, nagkaroon tayo ng division. So, maybe they have also made this as template, or they do tinagbasaranda. Shout out nga pala sa mga kwan dyan, sa mga nagre-review ng board. Mga taga-SESU na nagre-review. So, good luck sa inyong lahat. You take your food. Do not take your drinks yet. Mamaya na yun. Okay, so another one. Aside from this Roman Emperor Augustus, aside from the Statute of Winchester, that is under King Charles. We have also the modern policing in England. Yan. Bakit sir, pagka policing system eh, England yung bida? Kasi nauna sila sa tinatawag nating development. Development kasi, or civilization. Bakit sir, hindi ba tayo civilized? Ngayon, we are now civilized, pero nung una, talagang nauna sila naging civilized. They have the laws. Sa atin naman ay hindi masyadong na-develop yan. But since then, development came in the Philippines, at least we are now also developed. But of course, mas nauna talaga yung mga taga-Europe. Ngayon, we have the modern policing system. Of course, still in England. We have personalities. Pag-usapan natin yung mga personalities that were involved in the development of policing system. Una, Henry Fielding. Henry Fielding. Pangalawa, we have Patrick Colquhoun. Si Patrick Colquhoun. We have also Sir Robert, si Bobby. Sino ba si Henry Fielding? Who is Henry Fielding? Henry Fielding or Fielding, ito yung tao na malaking contribution sa development ng ating tinatawag na enforcement. Okay? And it was 1748, he founded or created, remember, yung si Henry Fielding, he founded or created the Bow Street Runners. Or the other name of this is the Thief Takers. Agalati agtatakaw. Okay. Ulitin ko, Henry Fielding, it was Bow Street Runners. Or the other term of this is Thief Takers. Yung nangunguha ng mga magnanakaw, hindi nangunguha, kinukuha, kinikidnap, hindi. They arrest. Okay? And became the chief magistrate, assisted by his half-brother John Fielding. So, dito yung kapsat na gito eh. Ngayon half lang. Okay? And then, you know, si Henry Fielding, siya ay naging chief magistrate. Pag sinabi natin magistrate in other areas, in other places, judge yan kasi. Judge. So, yan si Henry Fielding. Gumawa siya ng grupo. He made this Thief Takers. So, they arrest mga magnanakaw. Then, luckily, meron siyang kapatid. Sinong kapatid niya? Si John Fielding. Na tumulong din sa kanya in the creation and in the development of ASATS. Okay? Then, later, Henry Fielding succeeded as the chief magistrate. Pero mo, dito sa Pilipinas, ang tawag natin sa kanya ay chief justice. Pero sa kanila is magistrate. Now, ano bang other functions or other thing na ginawa or nagawa ni Henry Fielding? Actually, si Henry Fielding ay gumawa siya ng first professional police force. Yan, first professional police force. Subig ba sabihin, yung mga naunang police force, hindi ba professional ang mga yon? Well, we are not telling na those are not professional people kasi they are doing the police, but maybe the level is not yet that off very high. Pero ngayon dito on the time of Henry Fielding, ito yung ano, yung gumawa siya ng police force pero considered as professional. Considered as professional. So ngayon, itong ginawa ni Henry Fielding also considered as the foundation of all model of all modern police forces. Not only on that area but all over the world. All over the world. Then si Henry Fielding able to publish yung pamphlet niya. Ang title niya is Inquiry into the Causes of the Late Increase of Robbers. Yan, yung kanyang nagawang book or pamphlet na pinamigay as part of yung tinatawag nating information dissemination. Okay? Now, in this area, sino yung mga members of thief takers? At ano yung function nila? Hindi lang yung literally thief takers sila, but ang function nila ay to ensure yung crime prevention. Okay? And sino ba sila? Who are these people? They are private citizens. They are private citizens. Then, they became police officers. Parang police din ngayon. Naging private na tao, naging police. Hindi yung sundalo ka, pagiging police. Hindi. Ito, mga private people who became police officers. Then, anong function nila? To ensure yung prevention of crime. Another one is, of course, to do patrol. And then, si Henry Fielding, meron siyang talagang advocacy. He has that advocacy. Ano yon? Yung he spread the awareness about social problem, and that social problem is yung tinatawag nating criminality. Yan. Si Henry Fielding, kasi yung chief magistrate yan, magaling yan. Ang gusto niya, malaman ng tao kung ano talaga ang problema in the society at paano susolusyonan. And ang sabi niya, okay, ang problema natin is yung criminality. So, ibig sabihin, noong unang panahon, meron ng crimes. So, hindi lang ngayon ang may crime, but even before. Actually, on the Bible, meron ng crimes doon. Sino yung unang nag-commit ng crime? Yun si Adan, di ba? Ano bang kinumit? Ay, si Eva pala, si Eva. Eva, then si Adan. Nag-commit sila ng crime, then they were ousted in they were ousted in the Garden of Eden. Yun ang rason bakit napatakyas sila doon. Kasi they committed a violation against the rule of God. Yan. Another one, yung advocacy ni Henry Fielding. Bakit siya gumawa ng Bow Street Runners or the Thief Takers? Ano pa? Gumawa siya nito, unang-una, is not only for the arrest or apprehension of a such criminal, but ito, gumawa siya because ginawa niya ding bread and butter or source of bread and butter of few peoples, especially those members. Kasi ito, itong bow runners na ito, meron na silang sweldo. It's no longer voluntary na kahit walang sweldo or free. Hindi siya, natawag nating free lang na nag-work sila. Kaya nga, professional police force yan, kasi unang-una, they became, this organization became as their profession. Yan, profession na. Kaya, mga kapatid, ito yung unang tinatawag na professional police force. Kasi yung mga tao dito na involved, meron na silang sweldo. Kasi naging profession na yan. Ibig sabihin, if you work as a police officer, you must be paid. At least mababayaran ka matbasita. Dama di pang bitsin nga ko natayuan niya. Okay? So, ito yung contribution ni Henry Fielding with the help of his half-brother, si... Anong pangalan ng kanyang kapatid? Meron siyang kapatid. Si John. Si John Fielding. Pero si Henry Fielding, yan yung main character on the so-called Bow and Arrow. Bow Street Runners or the Thief Takers. Okay. So, another one personality na included in the development of this enforcement was Patrick Colquhoun. It was late 1700s. And Colquhoun is a Scottish magistrate. May samot nga judge ito eh. He developed the science of policing or the study of the policing. Sino to? Si Patrick Colquhoun, Scottish magistrate. He is a magistrate or a judge. Suggested that police functions must include detection of crime. So, itong si Patrick Colquhoun pala, siya yung nag-develop yung tinatawag nating police visibility or yung police omnipresence. Bakit? Kasi itinutulak niya ito yung tinatawag nating detection of crime. At another one, apprehension of offenders and prevention of crime. And sabi niya, the essay on... Okay? I'm sorry, medyo mahina yung signal natin. And this study or science of policing under Patrick Colquhoun the study was made also to help some scholars. Okay. Sino? Si Cesar Beccaria. On his study, yung crimes and punishment. Kasi si Patrick Colquhoun, he introduced yung tinatawag nating detection of crime. Pag na-detect yung crime, not only detection, nandyan din yung apprehension of the offenders. Apprehension. No other crime nga naarami. So, of course, somebody made it. So, nandyan yung apprehension of offenders. Another one, crime. Yung prevention of crime, then yung police visibility. If you put police officer standing there, maybe in the streets, they are preventing crime. Bakit? Bakit sila nagpa-prevent ng crime? Merely standing on the streets, wearing their uniforms. You are preventing crimes. Paano? Kasi matatakot naman kasi yung mga taong gumawang crime pagka may mga police. Walang daga. Tumatakbo ang daga. Pero ngayon, baliktad na ata kasi mga pusa maliliit eh. Yung mga daga mas malaki kaya. Kaya takot na yung mga pusa. Pero ngayon mga kapatid, sinabi nating police visibility, the function of that is to prevent crimes or to prevent those would-be criminals in performing or in doing crimes. Okay? Itong si Patrick Kulkohon, able to help also si Cesar Vicaria. Okay? Especially on crimes and punishment. Crimes and punishment. Right? And Kulkohon, able to publish a book known as The Commerce and Policing of the River Thames. Bakit? Kasi meron siyang inaral dito na yung commerce at saka policing, pag mahina yung policing system, yung ang commerce or maganda yung tinatawag nating pag-develop ng isang area. Okay? So, this study was made by Patrick Kulkohon. Another one, another thing that Mr. Kulkohon or Patrick Kulkohon made ay itong ano, ito, he made a centralized police board and he able to create the so-called intelligence service. Itong si Patrick Kulkohon. Biro mo, he centralized the police organization on that area, then able to make a such intelligence service. Walang nakaisip nun. Siya ang nakaisip. Yung intelligence service. Sir, gaano ba ka-importante yung intelligence service? Very important yan, yung intelligence. Kasi, if you don't know how to mahina yung organization. Nandyan yung MIS. Nandyan yung sa Russia, yung KGB, yung Committed Gusudros Binoy Pesobesnosti. Yan yung mga malalakas na intelligence. Of course, yung CIA. Kung malakas yung intelligence mo, malakas kang country. Si Patrick Kulkohon made a such intelligence service and able to centralize yung ano, yung police force. Other one, maintain a register of known offenders with classified information about particular groups. Ang napakaganda na in-study ni Patrick Kulkohon, enforcement, tawag nating record. He able to maintain the record of those people who are actually committing crimes and those persons who committed crimes. So, ito, we able also to get this. Or, we are now using this, yung use of records. The use of records. Sa Japan, napakaganda yung recording nila doon. Actually, fingerprints, body physics, sa computer. Sa atin naman ngayon, we are very lucky, meron na. Kaya nga pag kumukuha ka ng police clearance ngayon, pagka kunwari you committed crime in Mindanao, then you able to move into maybe here in Luzon kasi very elusive ka. Atakas ka diyan Mindanao, nakapunta ka dito sa Luzon, then kukuha ka ng police clearance mo, Dacat Luzon Sanchez, and then you ask for police clearance. Makikita na yung kaso muna doon sa Mindanao dito sa Sanchez. Kasi meron na tayong national recording that is under, special sa crime, under sa PNP. meron na silang data banking. Data banking. Another one, another contribution of Patrick Kulkohon, yung tinatawag nating police gazette or gazette. Parang kwan, parang newspaper. He able to do that. And the purpose of that is to inform people regarding the activities of the police, yung tinatawag nating information dissemination. Yan, actually sa PNP natin meron din yan, yung police community relation nila, yung PCR. Yung police ngayon, yung PNP natin ngayon, meron silang PCR, yung police community relation. They are giving pamphlets, okay? They are doing such seminars for the citizen. Yan, yung mga activity nila ngayon. Actually, ayan ay maybe copied or there be Kulkohon. We have also Bobbies. Diba? Pag Robert ang pangalan mo, pangalan mo ay Bobby. Okay? Sir Robert Peel, it was 1829. Okay? Pasensya na mahina ang ating internet. Or mahina sila. Sir Robert Peel, it was 1829. Philippines Metropolitan Police, wala. Wala. Ito yung ating template. Si Sir Robert Peel, ang kanyang nagawa in the development of law enforcement, he established the London Metropolitan Police. Metropolitan Police. Ito yung nagawa or it was enacted on the parliament in 1829, and this became the world's first modern organized police force, and it became the template or model ni Sir Robert Peel, ay naging model ito ng Amerika. Okay, naging model ito ng Amerika. And definitely ginamit din ito ng other countries like Great Britain. Kasi itong ginawa ni Robert Peel, yung London Metropolitan Police, may uniform sila, may baril sila, may mga system ang mga yan, may sweldo yan, may mga ranks yan, and different benefits and so on. Okay? Iyan yung ginawa. That is why it was. And ito, the Metro Police Force, also called as the Scotland Yard. Tinawag nilang Scotland Yard. Okay? Scotland Yard. Ano pa? And Sir Robert Peel was then considered as the father of modern policing or the father of modern law enforcement. Yan. Pero walang mother, ha? Wala tayong mother dito, eh. Okay? Only father. The father of the modern policing system was Sir Robert Peel. Ayan, mga kapatid. Those are the persons really included contributed much in the development of law enforcement. Okay? So, yan muna ang ating pag-uusapan ngayon. We will continue then by tomorrow, again, the same time or maybe morning or afternoon kung walang meeting sa school. So expect meetings or expect lecture like this. Manood lang kayo para wala naman kayong babayaran dyan, eh. Okay? So medyo lobat kasi itong cellphone ko. But before we go further, shout out kay Jepong dyan. Kay saka si Brick, saka si Aldong dyan. Nanonood na nagsashot. Pulpulutan da iti makun ko ng kwa. Parangipang barangbang ken pako. Okay? So we have here people who are watching, and good evening sa inyong lahat. Nandito si Noel Guzon, JR Agulyana, si Danggan, yeah. Si Ramoran, Caroline Sagli, good evening my friend, si Ambala, si George Dumayas, we have Daguhoy, si Erimark Karaang, Maynard Pailogna, we have Mark Valencia, si Marlon Idol Pader, si Vince R. Cosip, yan, si Joshua Sanchez, si Engelbert Feliciano, good evening Idol. Jenny B. Garduque, yan, good evening Jenny. Then JM Yabes, good evening JM. Ayan, si Cancer Gaming, si Akdal ito eh. Ayan, si Nasasakdal, good evening Nasasakdal. Si Arnold Valderrama, si Fuji Trumpo. Ayan. Okay lang, manood na lang kayo dyan. Si Mark Jelico Gardoke. Ayan, si Fidel Paturay. Ayan, Fidel Castro. Ayan, Fidel Paturay. Marjon Urena, Mark John Nefulda, RJ Siriban, Crisel Ann Tabieros, si Ray Gamueda, si Jepong Jepong, sabi niya dito. Ba? Shout out sir, ayan, si Karaang, shout out sa iyo, man. Mark Nefulda, thank you. So again, I give you information if you will have another lecture, but you expect, kasi nag-start na yung classes natin. You expect classes like this again. Medyo lat lang kasi ang cellphone ko. Hindi ako nakapag-charge kanina. Okay? So again, thank you very much for watching and good evening. Mabuhay kayong lahat.
Paano nag-robot tayo?